Hi, this is Dr. Rahul Pandya. Welcome to our channel. In today's episode, we will discuss self-plagiarism and various subtypes of self-plagiarism. Before we begin, if you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe and hit the bell icon so you wouldn't miss the upcoming episodes. We often copy the content from our previously published articles, book chapters, project proposals, term papers, reports, etc., and present similar information as new without acknowledging the previous work. Definitely, we can reuse the information from our previously published work under the fair usage policy. However, we must acknowledge the sources. There are several other forms of self-plagiarism, such as submitting one paper to multiple journals and conferences to increase the chances of acceptance, framing multiple articles from a single paper employing minor changes without presenting substantially new contributions, submitting the same project proposal to multiple funding agencies. Students often submit the same project reports, term papers, assignments, etc. to multiple courses. Let's take hands-on exercises and understand them one by one. Here we can observe that the article presented on the left-hand side is an older one that is assumed to have been already published. We employed the minor changes in the existing script without presenting substantially new contributions and submitted to another publishing platform. This is called self-plagiarism. The next paper can be an extension of the previous work. However, the extended version of the previously published article must present a substantially new contribution and extended solution, demonstrating new results, enhancing and eliminating the limitations of the previously presented methods. Multiposting is a subtype of self-plagiarism, which also comes under intentional plagiarism. The author submits one paper to multiple journals to get a quick response. Journals also have the plagiarism and multiposting checker. Consequently, such authors may be blacklisted and barred from future submissions. Therefore, one must preserve publishing ethics in the research and publication process. Similarly, multiposting will happen with the project proposal submissions also. Often we try to submit one project proposal to multiple funding agencies, which is highly unethical. To detect such instances, funding agencies may have plagiarism and multiposting checkers. Consequently, such authors may be blacklisted and barred from future submissions. Furthermore, the author splits one paper into multiple smaller versions with minor changes and submits them across various platforms. There should be at least a certain percentage of new contributions in each version. In the upcoming episodes, we will cover another plagiarism type in detail with a hands-on exercise. Therefore, please subscribe to our channel so you wouldn't miss the upcoming episodes. Before we leave, please do not forget to like and share. Thank you very much.